Thank you. But first of all, I've got to say, we are both from the same place, aren't
Swindon.
We? Both from Swindon. And we've got a friend, haven't we, in common?
Yes,
Claire.
Hello, Claire.
You know she's going to be watching.
Yeah.
But I've got to ask you, when I was a teenager, there were all these places which are the cool places to hang out. Mm-hmm. Are they still the same? Do people still go roller discoing at the Oasis?
At the Oasis.
They do!
Brunel Rooms,
Nappy Night.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, definitely.
That's not changed at all.
No.
And Saturday night, walking around town, because you can't get any pubs.
Yeah, that's right.
So anything you can do for a social life.
Old Town.
Nothing's changed,
still Swindon.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, and you're still living at home, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I go home occasionally, but I'm travelling around a lot at the moment. I'm in America a lot this year, and I'm in Europe, and, you know, everything's quite crazy and manic, so I don't really get home a lot. But when I do get home, you know, obviously I spend most of it in Swindon.
Yeah, and you're back with your mum and dad.
Yeah.
But are they strict with you? I mean, are they like any other normal teenage girl? Do they say, you know, you're getting ready for the Top of the Pops, for example, and they say, you know, you're not going out wearing that.
Yeah.
Change it, you're not going on television like
yeah,
that.
Well, that's what my dad's like. He hasn't seen my outfit tonight.
Okay, Billie, I'd just like to say, Dad, take a look at this. Turn around, Billie, turn around. Look at that.
No, he'll go crazy.
But she looks fantastic. You do look fantastic. And it's warm anyway, isn't it?
Yeah, so it's warm here.
Exactly. You've got to dress to suit the climate. That's what I always say. My case has not been a lot, but still.
Right.
But what about, have you ever been grounded? I mean, do you get...
Oh, like, yeah. When I first went to number one with Because We Want To, I don't know, I think I was cheeky to my mum or something and I was grounded after that. So, you know, they're my bases now, my parents. And although we've got more of a friendship, more than, you know, parent, you know, child relationship, I still treat them as authority and they still make the rules. But we've got, a better relationship now.
But I can't believe that. You got grounded when you were number one.
I know.
Oh, that's so bizarre, isn't it? So it's like, but Dad, I've got the Brits this weekend. Please let me go.
It's really crazy. But, you know, I think you have to be on that basis, you know. I think you have to have those kind of people around you, because when you start to believe the hype, that's when it gets too much.
That's when it goes all insane,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, and my parents are so down to earth, and, you know, they give me so much advice, it's so enthusiastic, which is really good for me, especially when you're surrounded by a lot of people that will feed you wrong information,
or just tell you exactly what you want to hear.
You need criticism.
Yeah. So do you still have to do the washing up and things like that?
Well, occasionally when I go home, Mum's like, oh, empty the dishwasher and things like that.
No, but
I like doing things like that. I'm actually quite a homely girl now. I don't really go out a lot anymore. I really appreciate going home and just sitting in the living room.
It's strange, but it does that to you, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really does. Yeah. Everyone's like, oh, you go out to all these glam parties and it's all like that, and it really isn't.
Yeah.
I think you don't appreciate your homely life until you're having to do it, and it's not such a novelty anymore.
Exactly.
You know, eating out all the time, it's like, it's cool, but it's not a luxury.
Exactly.
So it's good to just go home and slob out in front of the TV.
Clean the fridge out for five hours. I'm contented, actually. You should be out partying. No, cleaning the fridge out. Much more exciting.
Yeah.
Now, your songs really typify the teenage attitude, don't they? Which is quite surprising, actually, when you see your songwriters in action. Have a look at this.
I've got it. Have you got a boyfriend? Can I get your number?
Yeah, that'll do. And if Billie don't want it, we can always flog it to George Michael. Maybe do a video in a Kazi or something.
Sweet as a nut.
Crazy. Is that how it works? Is that how it really works?
I've never seen it quite like that before.
Well, we have now got a quiz for you, Billie, to see whether all of this, you say it's nervous at the beginning, see whether all of this has changed you, whether stardom has changed you, or whether you still are a normal teenager, or whether you're a mega pop star, or whether you've been moulded into something completely different, like, say, a freshwater fish.
Okay.
So, we're going to play Teen Queen or Bream. Okay, now are you ready for this?
Right.
Partisan quiz. Okay, so question one is, it's a Saturday night. Do you A, meet your friends in the park and drink cider on the swings? Or B, go to a swanky restaurant opening with showbiz pal Kavanagh? Or C, congregate in a shoal around jetties, bridges and fallen trees?
I don't know where I fit in there, actually.
A, B or C, meet your friends in the park, cider on the swings, swanky restaurant, or congregating around jetties?
I suppose it was, well, if I was still in Swindon, I'd probably still be going to the park. But as I'm working a lot, it's probably the restaurant.
Restaurant, okay. So you're going for B there. Okay, now question two. Are you preyed upon by A, the spotty boy at the back of the class, B, paparazzi and autograph hunters, or C, heron?
Heron? A.
A. So you're going for the spotty boy at the back of the class.
Right.
Okay. And the last question. You're shopping for food. Do you A, pop into QuickSave to pick up some alphabet spaghetti, B, wait in the limo while your butler pops into Harrods for some veal, or C, feast on bloodworms in the silt at the bottom of the river?
What's that all about?
I don't know.
I'll go for A.
A. Okay, so let's just have a little recap there. So we've got two A's and one B. Well, that means you mostly answered A. So, Billie, as if you didn't know, you're a teenager at heart.
Cool.
That's it for the moment. Thank you very much to Billie.
Come on, buzz me up to heaven, baby. Honey, to the beat. I close my eyes and I see you clear. It feels like you're lying here. All the things I wanna say come and go. Easy as a breeze, those words just flow. I float on air. Your love so sweet, like an open flower. I'm dizzy from the time we spent together. I need that horny drip every hour. I'm thinking about it, your sugar lips. Got a feeling for you now that's so strong. I'm dreaming of the candy in your fingertips. Baby, don't stay away from me too long. I've been missing you, I should be kissing you. Honey, to the beat, that's you. I wouldn't tell a lie, got a love I can't deny. Honey, to the beat, that's you for me. Honey, to the beat, that's you for me. Honey, to the beat. Come on, bust me up to heaven. You make me smile, but you're far away. Your voice like it was yesterday. All the things you do, they make me feel so fine. I gotta tell the world about a love that's mine. These wings to fly are gonna last forever. Cause one, my dreams come true. And I touch the sky whenever we're together. I can't believe the joy I get with you. I'm thinking about your sugar lips. Got a feeling for you now. I'm dreaming of the candy in your fingertips. Baby, don't stay away from me too long. I've been missing you, I should be kissing you. Honey, to the beat, that's you for me. I wouldn't tell a lie, got a love I can't deny. Honey, to the beat, that's you for me. Honey, to the beat, that's you for me. Honey, to the beat, come on and bust me.
Honey, to the beat, that's you for me. Honey, to the beat.